Okay, so that's extracted. Let's change into the directory and begin with cleaning the source up. So create a single file, make some symlinks, and install the platform specific header file. So make a directory, copy some files and some more, and then across platform kernel header files, and it says to create an empty autoconf file, and that should be it. And we can move on to Glibc next. So what does it say here? So before you start to install glibc, you must cd into the glibc directory and then unpack glibc Linux threads. Now, I believe if you forget to do that, I can't remember if it's during the configuration or during the compile, it will say that it expects to see it. Yeah, it might be during the configuration, actually. And you have to specify a command line option saying that, you know, you don't want to use it explicitly, so it is expected to be there. And this is what I was talking about earlier on, about all the instructions aren't actually in these box outs. You do have to read stuff to make sure you have a successful build. Okay, so we'll change into the directory and extract xjvf, extract glibc Linux threads where we are, as it says here. So change into the directory and unpack Linux threads in that directory. Okay, that's it. So now we should be able to start with the instructions to build. So we need to make a directory, touch a file so that it exists to prevent a warning, apply a patch, create a temporary directory for building in, and configure glibc for building. And it says you might see a warning there. I did get a warning, but it was about autoconf missing, I think, but not about message format, so that's okay. Okay, I'm not sure if that was there. I missed it, I think. Yeah, I missed it. So it's not actually complaining that. It could have been on the 6.3. I've just done that recently, so I'm sort of getting too confused, I think. So that's configured, run make, and I believe this takes about 2.5 hours or so. So it'll take a little while. Okay, so yeah, that's taken about 2 hours 20, 2.5 hours in fact, and we can carry on. I'm not going to do the tests, so I ran them when I was testing this, and they seem to pass okay. The important tests in chapter 6 I ran as well, and I didn't get any errors at all there, so it took an hour and a half to run the tests at this point. If you want an indication of how long they'll take. Sorry, that was 2.5 hours, that isn't it? 120. Yeah, 2.5 hours. I'm not sure if I said an hour and a half. 2.5 hours for the build, and the test took an hour and a half. So I'm going to install this now. Another thing I noticed was I heard the disk rattle around a few times during that build, and it was using the swap file. It used about 60 megabytes of swap file, but only for a matter of 10 seconds at the most, 15 seconds perhaps, generally just a few seconds while it was linking certain packages by the looks of it. So the swap would be important. That indicates it needs a minimum of 128 megabytes, given there's 64 mega memory, but obviously it didn't have a huge impact on the total time. As I say, it was only a matter of seconds that it was swapping for. Okay, now we can install all the locales or just enough for the tests. I'm not running the tests, but I'm going to install them anyway. And I'll install one for Great Britain as well, for my home country. So if you did install this, I have run it once, I think, in my time, but it just takes forever, especially on the older machines, and there's very little point. Unless you know you're going to need all of them or a majority of them. Okay, just the last one to do that, and then I'll add in my own one. So I'll just change this to GB, otherwise the rest of it's the same. Move on to locking in glibc. So it says now that the temporary C library has been installed, we want all the tools compiled in the rest of this chapter to be linked against these libraries. To accomplish this, we need to adjust the linker in the compiler specs file. First, install the adjusted linker by running the following from within the bin utils build directory. So we need to go to bin utils build, then we run this command, which is what we prepared before we built glibc, as it says here, everything will link only against the libraries in tools lib, and then we create this spec file and remove some include files, and then we run some simple tests to make sure that the tool chain is working as expected. And as you can see, that we would expect this response requesting program interpreter tools lib ldlinux.so.2, so that's all okay. So this completes the installation of the self-contained tool chain, and it can now be used to build the rest of the temporary tools. So we can now tidy up bin utils build, bin utils 2.14, glibc build, and glibc 2.3.2.